inspired you to write The Myth of Black Capitalism?
Well, we're talking about taking your viewers back in time. We're talking about 1970, 71. Now, you got to remember, we're coming out of the 60s now. And the 60s, as we well know, particularly the late 60s, 67, 69, and then the 70, you're talking about the Black Panther Party, you're talking about Black nationalism, you're talking about Black militancy, Black radicalism. You're talking about a lot of things in that period. Remember now, we're getting past Dr. King and civil rights. We're now getting into a whole other phase of the Black struggle, the militancy, the phase. So as a college student, we had on my campus, California State University, we had the second Black student union. Back then, the whole thing was forming Black unions on campuses. San Francisco State was the first. California State University, where I was the second. So we had a radical tradition. So I came, so I'm grounded in that. But even more grounded in Marxist ideas. That at that time was starting to gain a lot of credence. And we had study groups, reading some of the classics from Marx, Engels, Lenin, Mao, and of course, Kwame Nkrumah, the African Marxists. So all of these things, you know, they were having an influence. Now, Christopher, what happened? Richard Nixon comes along, President Nixon. And he says, we're going to, and it was pretty clever what he tried to do. We're going to co-opt Black militancy. And the way he did that is Black capitalism. Black capitalism. We're going to create and we're going to build a Black capitalist class. Small business people, entrepreneurs, tradespeople, craftspeople. Use them. Capitalism works. Blacks now can be, in fact, major players in the capitalist game. So all of these things coming together, the radical tradition, things I was involved with, the readings, Nixon now putting Black capitalism on the table. And by the way, Christopher, when he did that, that really set off a chain. There was a huge debate. I mean, I can't emphasize enough, huge debate within the African-American communities, and especially the intellectual communities and the business community about Black capitalism. What does it mean? Can it happen? Is there anything to that? Can that really be a reality? One other thing, the NAACP, they were beginning to change. And the Urban League, but especially the NAACP, they were beginning now to pick up on that. Well, hey, maybe the best way is now, not the marches, not the protests, the demonstration, but let's build up some Black millionaires. Let's build up some big Black capitalism and a Black capitalism. Man. Now, money will solve the problem. That is the path to liberation. Not marching, not protests, not political action, but hey, baby, dollars, 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 you know, becoming wealthy, becoming a player in the capitalist game. Somehow, in the minds of many, and by the way, a lot of people bought into that, saying, hey, you know what? They're right. So I felt I had to debunk that. I had to debunk that by not only looking at the present, but also going back in time and putting a history to it. Black capitalism, we have to realize, it's not new. Nixon coined it as a buzz concept. But, you know, we've always going back almost to the beginning, even in slavery, you always had a free Black population, not big, but you always had free Blacks. And you always had, even in the era of the 1850s, the 1860s, that even during slavery, you had some Blacks that were business people and tradespeople. So that's not a new concept. You know, capitalism, business, trading, building assets. And then over time, we've always had a Black business class. You know, in the South, even in the height of segregation for 60, 70 years, you had very successful Black insurance companies. They call them Negro insurance companies, Negro-owned banks, Negro-owned retail stores. So that's not, there's nothing new about that. What was new about it, Nixon and the rest put black on it. When they put black on it, it made it seem like it was something totally different, revolutionary.